This is example 3.4 of your textbook, used in your lab 3. It presents a Verilog example of combinational logic modeled with Boolean expressions. The programs have been written. The one that contains the actual model is exam3-4.v. So this is the program. It is an implementation of these two equations, E equals A of B and C, or B dash and D, and F is this. So this Boolean one is copied from your textbook. It uses an older notation. So the output and input notations are outside of the function parentheses. And now note that the default is 1 bit wide wire. So E, F, A, B, C, D, all these are 1 bit. And we use the assign statement to assign E, the output, to be A, two vertical bars means OR, B and C, this is N, logical N, and NOT B and D. Same thing for F, NOT B and C, or B and NOT C, and NOT D. So a strict implementation of these two equations. And then N module. Now this is Boolean 1. Okay. Now we can also implement this using a newer notation. In the newer notation, we just put the keywords output and input inside the parentheses. Okay. And we call this module more Boolean 2. So we have output E, output F, input A, input B, input C, input D. And the equations are the same. There's an advantage of using this new notation, as you will see in our test bench. The test bench is to test our module. Now first, after written this, we can compile, see whether we have any typo error. So there's no error. And that means there's no typo error. So now, here's the test bench program. Now we can directly include our module file, but we do not do it here. Instead, we link that together using the compiler. So we call this module, we call it test boolean. And as before, we declare the inputs as reds and outputs as wires. So we have red A, B, C, D, and wire E, F. Now, we will test the two modules, one the older version, the other one the newer version. So we have another set of outputs E2, F2 to test the other function. The newer function. So first, we have to initialize all the variables, and we will display, say, the time, and then the input variables A, B, C, D, and the output E, F, E2, F2. Say the time, we denotify dollar sign time. The formatter is percentage G, and all others are percentage B, means 1 bit, okay, which could be 0 or 1. And at the beginning, all values, input values are 0, A, B, C, D. And we finish after 75 time units. And we terminate the simulation. and always begin. So we start with all this, always begin. So all these are executed in parallel, okay, not in sequence. That means whenever you always begin, they are all executed simultaneously. This statement is very straightforward. Number five, that means after 5 units, time units, D is changed to a negation D, a complement. That means if it is 0, it becomes 1. And 1 after 5 units, it becomes 0 again. And for C, after 10 units, it becomes complement of C. And for B, we wait for 20 time units. For A, we do that after 40 time units. Okay. So that means D will be changed most frequently. Looks like the least significant input bit. So we just change this and see what our output will be. And here we have to connect the DUT. DUT is abbreviated, is an abbreviation of device under test, the test bench. And this is the old rotation. So we have test 1, E, F, A, B, C, D. Now this has to match our function Boolean 1, the order. So E, F, A, B, C, D should be in the same order. Same as E, F, A, B, C, D. But for the other one, Boolean 2, they do not need to be in the same order. Of course, you can make them in the same order, but they don't have to. As long as the names matches. So A goes to A, B goes to B, C goes to C, D goes to D, and E2, this output goes to E, and F2 goes to F. So each of these letters, say F, can be regarded as a port, and this F2 is plugged into the port F and receive the output. The same thing here, the A, dot A is the port, and then A is plugged into this port and send the input to the port. And suppose we compile this, I will not. Compile both of them. The default output is either out, and when we execute either out, so we get these outputs. So A, B, C, D, E. A, B, C, D are the inputs. E, F are outputs of Boolean 1. E, 2, F, 2 are outputs of Boolean 2. The new notation, you can see that D changes every 5 time units, so 0, 1, 0, 1, etc. And A changes every 40 time units, okay. And C 10 time units. Okay, so we cover all the values of A, B, C, D, and you can see the E, F outputs and E2, F2 outputs, they are consistent and they are the same. So you can try this yourself. And vary the variables and play with the results. Okay. Thank you. Bye-bye.